Good evening and welcome to Virtual Open House. You are watching the short version of my presentation for Open House. Just to make a note, there's also a longer version of this presentation that's available to you, and you can click that long version anytime you'd like. It'll remain posted in our Google Classroom, so you can come back and watch it anytime you'd like. That version's about 19 minutes long, and I go way more in depth into a lot of different parts of the course and just kind of reviewing different policies and things like that. So I know that's a significant time investment. So I wanted to also provide you with a quick summary or a short version of that presentation. And that's what you're viewing now. So I will try to be as brief as possible. My name is Russell Candela. I am your student's global history teacher. I teach currently three different courses, one of which your student is enrolled in. I teach a block global studies class, which is global one and global two, both courses, taught in 1 year, double periods. I also teach a section of Global 1, and I also teach a section of Global 2. So your student is enrolled in one of those courses, and I'm going to go over with you what some, briefly, what some of the expectations are. Just so you're aware, here is the syllabus. My email information is here, so you can pause this video at any time and jot this down if you'd like, or I could also provide you with a copy of the syllabus for yourself, and I will touch on that at the end. In the syllabus, I'm not going to go over every section of this. I do that in the long version. There's an introduction to the course. What are some course objectives and skills? Some materials, what your student needs to bring equipped, every day for virtual learning, whether they are hybrid, coming live or doing this virtually at home. They need these things regardless. There's also some information on here about the grading system as far as grading categories, how the student is graded, mostly classwork, the rest assessment. There's also a grading rubric on here, how classwork is graded specifically. It is my belief that it is the student's right to know that before they complete classwork. They need to understand how they're being graded. So this is provided to them also. The grading for writing assignments will change with each writing assignment. So students will be provided a grading rubric with each writing assignment. There's also information in here about expectations, the virtual attendance policy, assessment, how we handle assessment in the virtual world, some information about plagiarism. And again, my contact information, and on this syllabus, there is also a list of topics or units of study for each course. In the case of Global 1, it is this list here. In the case of Global 2, it is this list here. And in the case of the Block Global class, it will be all of these all in 1 year. So it's a lot of stuff, everything from, prehistory before the written word, all the way up until, very modern things, election years and climate issues and modern conflicts and things like that. So we go through a wide variety of things. We do most of our work through Google Classroom. For each course, there is a specific Google Classroom that students are enrolled in. Here is all units of study with the appropriate lessons for each unit. So in case your student is late on work or missing certain assignments, they could also always go back through here and complete missing work this way. The complete and total finished lesson is here for every one of these. Okay, so for every lesson, there is a presentation of the notes section, an activity, and resources. So they can basically complete the entire lesson virtually if they ever miss class. So all that stuff is here. So they can make up missed work very, very easily by going here. And this is for our period 3 and 4 block class, but the same is true for the Global 1 course, same thing here, and the Global 2 course also applies here. So also part of this virtual open house post on the Google Classroom, I've included this survey. This is just some basic information asking for the name of the student and the name of the parent guardian, and how you'd prefer to be contacted via email or phone. Email's easiest because I can correspond with everyone all at the same time if I need to. But there's also a space for your phone number. And then, how would you prefer to be contacted should the need arise, email or phone? And everyone that does provide an email address here on this form, I will send you your own copy of the syllabus. So again, I would like to be brief. So, I just wanted to introduce myself. If anyone has any other questions, I suggest if you find the time, watch the long version of this presentation first. I go into a lot more detail about a lot of these things, or feel free to email me and I will be happy to walk you through anything and answer any questions that you have. So I hope you enjoy the rest of your open house. Enjoy the rest of your evening and have a good night. Thank you.